Hi, my name is Carmelo Avila, and my teammates' names are Luis Benitez, Steven Santana, and Alicia Jill. Our project that we made was to design a wind turbine that produced energy with the power of the wind. With the wind energy that was captured by the wind turbine, it was able to turn on an LED light. Overall, the main point was to design a horizontal wind turbine that converts kinetic energy from the wind into electrical power.
Hello everyone, my name is Luis Benitez and I am here to inform you about some very important key terms that you should know before carrying on with this video. One very important key term would be wind turbine, which is a device that converts kinetic energy from wind into electrical power. A wind turbine is used for charging batteries that may be referred to like a wind charger, or it could be powering a DC motor, which we will be talking about in a moment. Another very important key term would be kinetic energy, which is energy that a body possesses by virtue of being in motion. Other key terms such as LED, a light emitting diode, is a semiconductor light source. Another very important key term would be a DC motor, which is a mechanically commutated electrical motor powered from direct current. The stator is stationary in space by definition, and therefore the current of the motor is switched by the commutator to also be stationary in space. Last but not least, electrical power, which is the rate at which electrical energy is transferred by an electrical circuit. The SI unit of power is the watt, 1 joule per second, and electrical power is usually produced by electric generators, which we will be showing you in a moment.
Hi. I'm Steven, and today I'm going to talk about design data and measurements. So we used a simple basic airfoil design for our wind turbine, and the whole purpose of this project is to power the LED light. The wind turbine is connected to the DC motor, which is inside the PVC pipe at the top. The PVC pipe's height is about 10 inches, and it has a rectangular base to keep it solid. The LED light is connected with the positive and negative copper wire. Each are connected to the motor, which when spun, connected to the rotor blade, will produce enough RPM to power up the LED. And the LED needs about 0.04 watts, which is about 2 volts. The simple aerofoil design helped because the wind force was actually quite high. I estimated that the wind speed is about 55. When it's about 55 miles per hour, it can generate enough force, electricity, to power the LED. And we used the aerofoil design. This is our simple thing we used. So as you can see here, we have the leading edge, which is at the top. We have the angle of attack. We have zero. So we have zone of positive pressure, which is at the bottom of the airfoil. This is where the rotor blade will be picking up speed. Zone of negative pressure, which just happens to be at the top. The chord line, the trailing edge. And so that's pretty much it for our design data. The LED The light emitting diode was quite a project. This project was fun.
Force is anything that can cause an object to undergo change, such as movement and direction. And in this case, it would be the blade interacting with the wind. And force can cause the velocity of an object to change in order to accelerate. And force does have both magnitude and direction, which makes it a vector. And the unit that is used to be compared with force is newtons, which is symbolized by a capital F. Since we have the diameter of the propeller was 12 inches, the wind speed was 55 miles per hour, and the LED light was 0.04 watts. For our scientific research and technology principles, we have that the wind turbine captures airflow by converting it into a rotational movement, which then generates electricity. And when air mass is flowing through an area A with the wind speed of V, the power of that air mass is generated by T equals 1/2 PAV of T.
The outcome of our mini wind turbine project, we learned that wind energy is a great resource to reduce the pollution in our world. Wind is a clean energy source that is endlessly renewable and reliable, which is good. We also learned that it takes the collaboration of all of us as teammates to make a project possible. Future improvements that we could make in our project is use better materials and not spend too much money on materials. Also, it would have been better in the future to have more teamwork and have better communication amongst each other.